Sana provides a startup wizard in SAP Business One. It is used to guide an SAP user through the main settings and master data that should be set up for a Sana web store. Sana Commerce Startup Wizard is the easiest way to perform the initial setup of a Sana web store and its data in SAP Business One right after the Sana add-on has been installed inside SAP. On the first step, you will be asked to set up the Sana Web Store in SAP. There you will need to enter the Sana Web Store ID, the one that is stored in the Sana SQL database, a customer template to show prices and inventory to the Web Store visitors, and order processing settings. Then you can set up rights in SAP that are used for extra sales costs coming from the Sana Web Store, like payments and shipping costs. In the Languages window, you need to set up all languages that are used in your Sana Web Store. A Sana Web Store is multilingual, and any language can be installed using a language pack. So, for all languages that are used in the Sana Web Store, you need to add Windows Locale IDs. In SAP, various data can be added in different languages, like product titles and descriptions. Thus, to show this data from SAP in the Sana Web Store, you should set up languages. In the Sana Web Store, there are a few places where a customer needs to select a country. For example, when a customer registers in the Web Store, enters a custom shipping address, or when a sales agent creates a prospective customer. The list of countries that are shown on those pages is coming from SAP. So, here you can specify which countries should be shown in your web store and assign a customer template to each country. A customer template stores a predefined data which will be used for registration of the new customers. Sana supports multi-currency. Customer's currency is set in the business partner master data, but in the currencies window you can set up the list of all currencies which should be used in your Sana web store. Only those currencies which are set as visible in the Web Store will be indexed by Sana and used in the Web Store. The same goes for units of measure. In the Sana Web Store, you can allow your customers to choose with which unit of measure to order a product. In SAP, you can set up multiple units of measure for a product and their conversion rules. In this case, a customer will be able to choose a unit of measure. In this list of all units of measure in SAP, you should define visibility for those which should be used in your Sana Web Store. Directly from the Sana Commerce Startup Wizard, you can manage item groups. In SAP, item groups are used to classify products. Item groups from SAP, together with the assigned products, can be imported into Sana to automatically build Web Store navigation and catalog. Here you can define which item groups should be visible or invisible in your web store. In SAP, you can define which products should be visible in your web store or hidden. While here, you can update visibility of all products that exist in SAP. When you update visibility of all products, at first products are validated by the rules of orderability, which are set in the data validation rules. And if a product is orderable, its visibility is automatically set to true. So, this is how you can set up a Sana Web Store in a fast and easy way, right after you have installed the Sana add-on on the SAP Business One workstation. Of course, all settings which you have seen in the Sana Commerce Startup Wizard can be configured or reconfigured later on individually from different places in SAP.